Donald Trump announces his plan to cut taxes. Hillary Clinton embarks on a new campaign strategy. And Speaker Boehner steps down, but the problems of Congress still remain. A perfect time for Politics Monday. I'm joined by Tamara Keith of NPR and Amy Walter of the Cook Political Report. And welcome to you both. So let's start with Donald Trump. He did finally today unveil this this tax reform plan, eliminate taxes for what millions of people, cut taxes for some of the highest income earners. Let's listen to a little bit of what he said at this announcement today.
We will run this country properly. There is so much money to be saved. We're reducing taxes, but at the same time, if I win, if I become president, we will be able to cut so much money and have a better cut. We won't be losing anything other than we'll be balancing budgets and getting them where they should be.
So, Amy, what was the reaction to this today in political and economic circles? Is this a plan that is likely to gain him support from voters?
Well, I've dubbed this the Oprah tax plan. It's a little bit like you get a tax cut and you get a tax cut and you get a tax cut. Everybody gets something. But unlike Oprah, we don't really know where the money's coming from. I know Oprah can pay for all the things that she gives away. This is a tax plan, though, that did get some conservatives with the thumbs up, people like Grover Norquist, who's a very influential Republican conservative tax fighter, doesn't want to see any tax increases ever. Even the Club for Growth, who's come out and criticized Donald Trump, saying that they don't think he's conservative enough, that he's hiked taxes in the past, or at least, I'm sorry, he's advocated hiking taxes. Even they had to concede. I think Donald Trump's doing two things here. The first is he's pushing back on the argument against him that he is not strong enough on policy, he's not doing enough to talk specifics, and number two, pushing back on this theme that people like Club for Growth have argued, that he's not a serious conservative, that he's not a real Republican. This tax plan helps to push back on both.
And we know part of it, a lot of tax cuts, but there is taking away the so-called carried interest favor that's been given to some of the hedge fund folks in New York. But Tamara, how does this compare to what other Republicans have been saying about what they would do about taxes?
In some ways, it's on steroids. It's like the Jeb plan on steroids. He is lowering the business tax rate, the corporate tax rate, to 15%. And in addition to cutting it from the 35 that it currently is, he also would take freelance income. He'd take small businesses that currently pay taxes at the individual tax rate. All of that would get pushed over and put on the corporate tax rate at 15%, which Grover Norquist, the anti-tax crusader, said was ambitious and bold. And the reality is this is a pretty specific plan. It includes a lot of details, new tax code, new tax brackets on the personal income side, a 0% bracket where he, in the plan itself, it says that there will be a page that you just fill out that says, I win.
But we do now know a little bit more, Amy, about where he's coming from on economics from this, right? I mean, at least this fills in some of that picture.
Yeah, sure. It says he wants to give everybody a little bit of something. He says he's going to pay for it by closing these tax loopholes, which most economists say it's not going to be possible. But we also know that he wants to do a lot of other spending that we also don't know where that's coming from. Building a wall across the border of Mexico, humanely rounding up immigrants, as he said the other night, having a health care plan that's not Obamacare but will cover everybody. It's not clear where that money's coming from.
All right, well, we've talked about Donald Trump, one of the Republicans. Let's talk about Hillary Clinton. Tamara, I guess her campaign has decided she's going to give more interviews. We've seen her popping up on different news programs, and she's everywhere she goes, she's being asked about those emails. It was no different yesterday on Meet the Press. Chuck Todd asked her some questions. Here is part of that exchange.
There are some things about this that I just can't control. I can't control the technical aspects of it. I'm not by any means a technical expert. I relied on people who were. My assumption was anything that I sent to a .gov account would be captured.
But you know, that's very difficult to capture all of your emails by going to perhaps thousands of people in their .gov accounts. It would have been a lot easier if it was sent to your .gov account.
Well, but when you communicate with people in other parts of the government, you're not sending it to the statedepartment.gov, and that would have been true either way. Look, I think I have done all that I can to, you know, take responsibility, to be as transparent as possible.
So, Tamara, what I noticed people are saying about this interview is she didn't seem as impatient with these questions as she has in the past.
She looked very relaxed, like, I'm
almost
going to
happy
sit
to be
here,
getting
and
questions.
I am going to be relaxed. and she was. But Chuck asked her at some point, is this just a drip, drip, drip? And she said, yeah, this is a drip, drip, drip. And this is going to drip, drip, drip. There's going to be another release of emails from the State Department later this week on Wednesday. And then come October 22nd, there's going to be this big Benghazi committee hearing. And there's no telling whether that's really going to be the end of it. Odds are it won't really be the end of it.
And so does her campaign, Amy, think they just have to slog through
yes.
this no matter what?
It's the, and you saw it both in her body language and when she acknowledged the drip, drip, drip. There's this resignation to her fate that I don't control this. I don't know what's going to come of it. All she can hope is two things. One, that this stays in the political realm. It doesn't go in the legal realm. We don't start talking about real serious legal repercussions, and two, that eventually the media and voters and the public get bored with this story and it does go away. But that is not anytime soon, and certainly not before the end of October.
Well, I can't let the two of you get away without asking you about the big news of last mm-hmm. Friday. House Speaker yeah. John Boehner announced he's stepping down. Yesterday, he did an interview on one of the Sunday shows with John Dickerson on Face the Nation. And we heard Boehner here spell out who some of these conservatives are who led to this decision. Here's part of that. So, Tamara, we hear what the speaker's saying. He's been pretty blunt there about is Kevin McCarthy or somebody else who, by the way, announced today he's running for the speakership, confirmed it. Are things going to be different under his leadership?
He's going to have the same math mm-hmm. problem that John Boehner had, which is in the House, Republicans can get what they want if they all agree with each other. Otherwise, they're going to have some Democratic help. And then it gets over to the Senate, and they can't blast through a filibuster. And then it would go to the Democratic president. And there's no way a Democratic president is going to defund Planned Parenthood or eliminate Obamacare. So they still have the same fundamental problem. Kevin McCarthy, I think, has better relationships with some of the most conservative members, but I don't know how far that will go.
So what changes, Amy?
We change chairs, and that's really about it. I don't think we're going to see much more out of a McCarthy speakership than we would out of a Boehner speakership. The one question is, how much does he accede to that conservative base? Does he say, fine, yeah, let's shut the government down over debt ceiling in December. Yeah, fine, let's go take more stringent positions, force the president's hand, which could create, of course, more gridlock. We could have another government shutdown, and we could get to the place where Republicans, especially those who want to win the White House back, say, this is damaging us beyond repair.
But there's no sign he's going to do some of those things.
What he's going to do. Right.
Well, that's why we have you
that's
two
right.
here to explain
we'll
it to
fun.
Us.
We'll be back
out.
To watch.
That's right.
Amy Walter, Tamara Keith, thank you both.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.